Hey everyone, Daniel here from TwinBytes with another quick tutorial for you. This time I'm showing you how you can have something set up that will help you identify if a link is safe to click on when you're doing a Google search for something. There's too many times people do a search for some support number is very common or other things, and they blindly, very quickly click on the link without checking to see where it's going, if it looks correct. And they end up going to some hacker's website and their computer becomes compromised. So in this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create an extension, add-on, plugin, whatever word you want to call it, as they're all interchangeable, between three different web browsers. So looking in the search results here, doing a Google search, I get a bunch of listings, and I've got an additional icon in the front of the name of the site, and they will have three different colors. So here we got a gray one, and that's showing a question mark on it. So it's not sure if this site can be trusted or not, and it's kind of funny because this is my own site, but because it's not a global company, I'm not a big brand like Facebook. You can see the next one down here. It's got a green shield with a white check mark. So this is a safe link to go to. However, this doesn't mean it's bad because it's gray. It just means there hasn't been enough votes on this site yet to confirm whether it's good or not. So you can scroll through the list and you'll see this just happens to have all green check marks. So these are all safe links to click on. Now, what you could do also is when you go to a site, if we're like, I know this is a safe site because it's my own. But when you're on the website, and you know this is a site you go to all the time and it's safe, then up in the top corner of your screen, you've got the icon, which will have a different look depending on if it was a trusted site already or not. This one's unknown because it says, as I said, we do not have enough information yet to rate this website. So it's not rated bad or good. It just doesn't have enough information to rate it yet. So down here, you can say, do you trust it? It says you trust it because I've already trusted it, so I can click to remove it, and now it asks, do you trust it? I could untrust it or I can trust it. So of course I'm going to trust it. It's my own site and I know it's clean. I know I don't have anything bad on there purposely, unless someone hacked into it and put something on there. But as far as I know, it is a safe site. So having enough people go on to a website and give it a thumbs up, that will then eventually send a signal to Avast to mark that site as safe. So the next time someone does a search for it, it'll actually show that it is known and trusted between many people. So I'm going to show you how you can add this on here on three different web browsers. So the first one is Firefox. If we go up to the little hamburger menu and then you can go down to add-ons, I've already got it in here. But if we scroll down to the bottom, there's find more add-ons. And then you can do a search for Avast online. It comes up before I even finish typing it in. Click on that, you'll see it appears. And you want to be sure it's got their logo and it's got their name here, and the link should take you to their page. So it does have the warning that it's not actively monitored for security by Mozilla because it's not a Mozilla add-on, because it's a Mozilla Firefox browser. So they can't confirm or deny the safety of this plugin, but I know it's safe because I know this brand, I know who they are, so it's fine. It would have a install link here, but mine says remove because I've already got it installed. And then it would be installed, and the next time you do a search, you will see these icons beside the name so that you'll know that it's safe to click on. So that's Firefox. Let's have a look at Chrome. So in Google Chrome, the little three dots in the top right corner. We'll go down to settings. extensions. Up in the top left, there's extensions, and down at the bottom, there's Open Chrome Web Store. Now, I believe I just took us the long way, but that's one way to get to it. So, searching the store, same thing, Avast Online Security. And it shows it right here. For me, it says added because it's already added, but it says again who it's from, it's got their website, there's the reviews for it as well. It's 25,000 votes from 10 million users that actually have downloaded it. Now here it says remove from Chrome, but for you it would say add to Chrome. And that would be it. You may have to close Chrome and open it again for it to work, but that's pretty much it. Just close out of all the tabs. And then let's just do a quick search on here as well. And you'll see it looks exactly the same. So that's Google Chrome. Let's look at the next popular browser is Edge. So with the Edge browser, it's similar in the top right corner. There's the three dots. And we'll go to extensions. And then this is searches the installed extensions. We want to go here, find new extensions, get extensions for Edge. And then do the search, Avast Online Security. It's even got their logo showing there. And it's got the name, it's got a link to their site. And again, great ratings that they're getting. Add-on already installed on your browser. So I would hit remove in this case because it's already added. And I'll just say I'm reinstalling it. I don't really need to go through this whole review, but here it says get. So the wording on some of these are different, and then there's add extension. So the other browsers may ask you add and confirm. Once it's added, you do have that up in the top, the same as every other browser. So again, let's search here and we will click up in here. And for this website, do you trust Google? Well, I'm not going to click on anything here. It is already marked as a safe site. But the results, you'll get the same. It doesn't matter which web browser you use. So that's it for this quick tutorial. I hope you guys did find it helpful. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And we'll see you in the next video. All right. Thanks so much. Bye for now.